Allan DeWitt with Belgotex New Zealand?
South Africa. But we have branches in New Zealand, Australia, factory in Brazil, associated weavers in Belgium, and Balsan in France.
A major problem here in the United States is a shortage of qualified installers. They basically have missed a generation or two. Most of the installers here in the United States are, you know, in their 50s, I would say. Do you have similar problems in the areas that you're involved in?
We have exactly the same problem, and not just in South Africa, around the world. I go to Europe and other countries often, and it's exactly identical shortage of skills. The skill being carried over from the grandfather to the son. Those days are gone. It's not a sexy job. It's a hard work, and those days are gone. So you need to find other initiatives to get installers in for the trade. Otherwise, you have nothing.
So how do you do that? You had told me earlier that you go into schools and recruit and educate kids. Is that a popular way to do it?
You know, it's not a very popular way, but we do that with schools, and we've had a lot of success. So in the schools, the students need to do their other subjects, and we present it over 2 years. And then we also put them through the 6 weeks training course. And you have a government assessor from our training authority that come and assess them, and through that they qualify for a national certificate. Other than that, we will approach contractors which have had installers for 3 or 4 months that they see potential in, and we'll bring those to our academy and put them through the 6 weeks course. Because by contract, they go back to that contractor, and we ensure in that manner that we create new installers and they stay in the system.
Are these new installers employees of the contractor, or do they work like they do here in many cases, our contract?
No, our agreement, in order, because we finance the project, in order for us to put those installers through, they need to sign a contract with that installer. So it ensures that for the next year or two thereafter, that guy go and he learns further and he stays in the system. Otherwise, the guys just start running around wanting to do their own thing.
Yeah. So then they have ongoing, by contract, ongoing education throughout their career?
Absolutely. So what we do is we multi-skill the guys. So they first go through the 6 weeks carpeting. Thereafter, when they've performed quite well, we'll put them through the vinyl and the wood laminate. When the contractor don't have carpeting work, you'll have vinyl work, wood laminate work, and we do refresher courses with them, etc.
If you are in the U.S., you're familiar, obviously, with the situation here in the United States. What would you do to help solve that problem here?
You know, the United States is quite exceptional in size to South Africa. We got to remember that. But what we have done, we have really followed what the CFI has done over the years with the 6 weeks course. We used to have a 1 year full learnership, which wasn't successful because the guys were 6 months in college, and then they go to the contractor for further training. When he get there, he doesn't have enough skills, so the contractor use him to sweep and carry boxes of material. So we decided to go to the 6 weeks course, like the CFI of a 5 weeks course, and it becomes a repetitive process where they keep doing the same thing, and we found it very successful. We've had 100% success rate.
What are your goals here coming this particular time to CFI?
There's always something new to learn. And one of the big things for me this year, since we got our formal academy going that started in January, was to share with Jonathan and see, compare what they do, what we do. We know about the program. We didn't exactly know what we included. But when we compared, we found that we're doing exactly the same thing. And that's where we both find our successes. And we also experience exactly the same difficulties in the same areas.
Allan, thanks so much for talking with us.
Thank you very much.
And you got a heck of a trip back, don't you?
Yeah, well, for us to get here from your first flight to here is about 30 hours. One flight, 16 and a half from Johannesburg to Atlanta. But you know what? It's worth it every year that I come.
There we go. Thanks again.
Thank you very much.
We've been talking with Allan de Witt, Belgotech, South Africa.
That's correct.
We're at the CFI convention in San Antonio, and this is Talk Floor TV.